Welcome to the video news of the week. The Weathervane Theatre and the community held a ribbon-cutting ceremony on August 9th to celebrate the completion of remodeling work after a fire destroyed the old barn theatre and a section of the new one last October. Much work had been done inside and out in the building, along with construction of a new carpentry and scenic shop near the main theatre structure. The rebuilding was completed in just under 10 months, just in time for the opening of the Whitefield Theatre's 47th consecutive season.
The Colebrook Recreation Department geared up for two musical performances during rehearsals this past week. The Junior Drama Club practiced their performance of Winnie the Pooh, while the Drama Club rehearsed Seussical's Horton Hears a Who. Both groups include participants from all around the area. The plays will be performed this Friday at 1 and 2 p.m. On August 12th, the Cookshire Fairgrounds were the site of the annual Old Fashioned Day. The event is held every year to raise funds for the Eaton Corner Museum. The afternoon was filled with exhibits and workshops, as well as plenty of homemade goods. Music was heard throughout the day, and demonstrations were given by local artisans.
White pine, yep.
Last Saturday was the annual barbecue hosted by Barry Berwick in Sorryville, Quebec. Over 150 friends and family members traveled to the barbecue, where a large amount of food is served. Musicians entertained well into the night. During the barbecue, regional pianist Jan Graham of Sorryville was recognized with a surprise plaque in the shape of a piano. They thanked her for all of her years of donating time and providing music for her friends.
A day of music was held at the Poore Family Homestead and Museum in Stewartstown. A number of local talents performed a variety of musical genres ranging from folk to rock and roll. All funds raised went to benefit the homestead, which was open for tours throughout the day.
We are leaving for our children better days have come and gone. We are leaving for our children, how will they ever carry on?
The Great Northwoods Committee for the Arts is preparing for its next concert. the country rock band Ladies of the Canyon. The group was formed when four women decided to get together and perform music influenced by their favorite bands, ranging from the Eagles and the Band to Fleetwood Mac. The concert will be held at 7 p.m. on Sunday, August 26th at the Tillotson Center in Colebrook. Tickets are now on sale for the show at $15 each. Our video footage is from July of last year when the group performed at the Fête de la Tenacion's main stage.
Colebrook Chronicle Video News of the Week is sponsored by the Upper Connecticut Valley Hospital in Colebrook. Visit their website at ucvh.org. Compassionate healthcare close to home. Steve Bissonnette, AAMS Financial Planning and Investment Management in Lancaster. Visit MrIRA.net. LaPerle's IGA of Colebrook. Great deals and instant coupons can be found on their website at LaPerle'sIGA.com. Colebrook Plumbing and Heating in Colebrook. Why heat with oil when you can heat economically with wood? Come see our whole house wood boiler solutions currently on sale. Murphy's Steakhouse at Bear Tree in Pittsburgh. Enjoy casual fine dining, a cozy atmosphere, and wonderful food. Try the chef's table on Sunday evenings. And by Woodsville Guaranty Savings Bank. Friendly local people, friendly local bank. And open 7 days a week inside Lancaster Shaw's. There's a chance of thunderstorms on Friday with a warm high of 78 degrees. Saturday clears up with a high of 71 and a low of 46. And Sunday rounds out the weekend with a high of 73 and a low of 47 degrees. Thank you for watching the Video News of the Week.